Okay, it's June 26, 2018. I just took pictures and did a short video of the large zucchinis we've got out here just about 5 minutes ago. There's the eggshells I brought here to put around the tomatoes. But this is what I'm talking about. That's up to my midsection, I guess you'd say. If I want to wander out there, it'll be right up to about, you know, my mid-belly. Not the big part, but the height. And this is yellow. Actually, there's two yellow over on the left side, and there's two green on the right. And they're so, I mean, I didn't realize they would explode this much, my goodness. And I thought I had them, you know, 3 feet apart, roughly. And you can see how full they are to get in there and get to the, there's a small zucchini down there. I don't know if I'm zoom in, if it'll shut off, because it's a Sony, and it tends to do that a lot. There's one down in there. Oh, come on. This autofocus crap on this Sony is BS. There's a small zucchini in there on the ground. Oh, there's one in there. I can see it here, the shiny. It looks like a big cucumber almost. That one's about, I would say about 8 inches slick, like something that most people, well, about 8 inches, like a large dill pickle, I guess you'd say. The okra out here is getting these Japanese beetles out here. I didn't bring it out with me. I should have the dishwashing liquid, water mix, 1 tablespoon dishwashing liquid to 1/4 water in a spray bottle, and that knocks them suckers off right away, and I did that before. And they stop, but see, it's rained a couple times since then, and I see some on here now, and you see the holes in the leaves, so I gotta get out here. But see, with the sun right now, I don't want to do that because it'll be too harmful for them. The soap water does not harm the plant so much, but the liquid with the sun out can help damage burn it. I've come out here and swipe these suckers off. These damn beetles. Get out of here. Yeah, we've already gotten some red okra out here. I don't know if there's any on here right now. But, you know, let these go. These get real long and they're thin. They're skinny pods. They get real big. The red ones do. Real big. They're like long, skinny ones. The green ones, there's one or two on here I saw. They're thicker generally. But they can get big if you don't pick them. And right down there, I don't know if you can see. Where's my finger? Let me see that one right there. Right here. Oh, that's a good size. That's what size people pick. That's about 4 inches. Yeah. Right here. See, this when this comes off, it's completely off. You pick them generally. You can pick them now, too. But just pull that flower off. There. I've eaten a couple of these raw out of the garden. These are real healthy for you, too. But see, that like I say, this is the only green one we have out here because I don't know why the others hadn't grown up, but we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there's another one down there, a small one, so if you want to say 6, but I say 5. And then this green one. I wanted to plant another one there. Had tried to plant one in the corner over there, but that's not going to work over there. So if anything, one right there with those two, I want to get a green one down there. Where those two, tomato sticks are. And then that's it, because we planted some peppers here. These are small out of the pot. That's why they're so tiny. You can see them down the ground there. Everybody seems to have peppers. I have a couple people I know have peppers about 18 inches, 2 feet high with flowers on them. Or one looks like a pepper just starting to pop out. And like I said, we usually have a good time with peppers. Not a good time, you know. But you see that, hot out here, folks. It says it's 88, feels like 96, so I understand why if I lose my breath. See that? That's a torch sunflower there. That's about the size of the peppers generally about now, and they'd be putting out flowers and peppers. But again, you see the small pepper, the small ones down there. Got two here, and we got six or I think 5 or 7 in the back. But I digress. Let me go over here by the See, the garlic's getting ready. There's a bunch of those they're turning, they're getting to the point where they need to come up. Got a few pea pods off of here. The purple hull peas are putting out pods. The black-eyed peas are putting out pods here. See the pods right here? The black-eyed peas really produce like crazy, man. They'll go all the way into October producing. This plastic keeps the ground about 10 degrees or warmer with the sun, I'm sure. If it's not feeling like 90 degrees to us, it's probably like 100 degrees on that ground, at least underneath the plastic. I got two hornworms off of here, out here. I gotta be careful where I'm stepping. Ooh, guys! Off this one right here. You can look at the branch and see this is what they'll do. See how they eat all the leaves off? They'll devastate a plant if you don't catch them. I thought I put them off and I stepped on that sucker this morning. My wife might have kicked it off to the side or something. Because I did a second one. I mean, that was yesterday, rather. This morning I got one off of this tomato plant. Right there it is. Just so you can see. Where's that? Right there. Right there. Yeah, I stepped on you. I see that stuff shoot out off of this tomato plant. This one's not wasn't bit up so bad. See, a sure sign is if you look at those little black pellets down there, that's their poop. I was out here. It was quiet this morning around 7 o'clock. And you could hear little things hitting the plastic. That's when I saw this one on here. There's a little one on here too still. See the branch right here? See that? I don't see the little one yet. But you see little specks of poop on the leaves. Where's that leaf right there? See that leaf right in the middle? Little black spot of poop. So there's one on here. I'll get it here sometime today. But yeah, anytime you see that stuff right there, those pellets, those little black pellets, that's poop from a hornworm. The calcium helps detract, the hornworm, plus it gives it calcium, the eggshells, I should say, that's the calcium, the eggshells. I got eggshells around most of these too, still, as you can see down there. These are really finely. We have coffin grounds on here, and then we have eggshells around them on top of that. But see, when you hold them tied up, they don't seem to really put out a lot. I don't know why, because it's too cramped. So I untied these, and you see the branches laying on the plastic, which is not in and of itself damaging. But the hornworms get out from the area there, the ground, and they get on those plants, and it'll decimate these in a day. So put eggshells down around it. I just have to check these later on around 6, 7 o'clock this evening. Oh, boy. See, I was going to eat this okra, but I'm going to save it in the house. That okra, like I said, when it starts putting out, we'll be putting out okra constantly. We got a spot right there where the eggshells are. Underneath that pot, that's 2, 3. Underneath that pot, 4, 5. 5 pepper plants are going to go over here. Because I thought the hornworm over on this other tomato plant got bypassed the eggshells and all that by using these melon plants, because it ate off them leaves like it has. So see, again, I can see the poop down there on the ground, but yeah, when you see a branch like that, that's definitely a sign of hornworms. Okay, so and then you see the pellets and you know for a fact you gotta catch them right away. Because one day, this whole plant would be eat up, and we've gone through it last year and the year before. Last year, not so bad, because the tomatoes didn't put out so much until the end of the year. But, yeah, you got to keep on top of it. Because unless something happens like it did to me last year with my health, I couldn't come out here as much as I wanted to. If my health stays okay, at least, I can mind the pain on my knees. They're wrapped up usually, but right now we have around 18 watermelon out here. At least 7 or 8 of them are close to 20 pounds, and these are honeydews, and then there are actual cantaloupes in here too. But 1, 2, 3, 4 tomato plants, and if you want to count that one, would be 5, and this one 6 and 7, and the one inside the melon plant here, 8 that are putting out tomatoes. Well, good size to put out tomatoes, of which 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them are putting out tomatoes right now. And like I said, I'm just going to go around and put a little of those eggshells around the bottom there. Crunched up eggshells is better. And pepper plants we put out here this morning. And hopefully this will grow now, being out here where it's got room to grow and breathe. Put Epsom salt and sugar. You dig it out. You put Epsom salt and sugar down there. Just a thin layer of soil between that. And then you put down the plant soil that's in the pot with the plant and put it down. So we'll see how they come out this year. I've got them all the way back here too, because you got all that stuff coming right toward us. Look how full that is. That's all your watermelons over there. And right about there should be some cantaloupe and honeydew. And there are actual cucumbers planted in there that's coming out. There's two cucumbers right down there. And there's one right there. And these holes I put 2 and 3 seeds in 3 spots. That one there. Where's it? Right there. And that one there, there's only one coming out of that one. Should be 2 or 3 in that one. And then I had them in here too, but none's coming out of this one. I don't think. I just see some green, but it might be a leaf down in there. Yeah, that is. That's a... It's noisy. I don't know if you can see it. Where's my finger? God bless it. Right there. There's a cucumber coming up right there. I put 2 or 3 in there, and then, like I said, I put 3 in one hole and 2 holes with 2 seeds. There's 1 seed coming up there. 1 there. 2 right there. Plus, like I say, the pointed leaves, as you look at the leaves in here, the leaf patterns, you can see the pointed leaves. The pointed leaves are the cucumbers. See the big one right up there? That's a cucumber. And then there's, like I say, honeydew, and then there's a couple. You can see the camera from the other side. If the camera doesn't shut off on me, I record it. I don't see the batteries flashing already. Make it over here to these watermelons, these big ones. You can't really see them good. I can see them with my naked eye. Right in there. In there. There. There's one back there. You can see it a little bit with the sun on it. See, that's what these leaves are. They're protected too. So here's one right here coming. And then you got little ones on there. Buds. Eggplant. Basil. Eggplant. Basil. Man, I gotta scratch my chest. It's itching. Being out here with all these insects. See, you can see watermelon down there. The sun getting on it. These leaves are to protect that too. That's why that I don't like that one being open bare like that. And quickly, here's the okra. You can see the flower inside that one. Yeah, they're getting okra. This is the red okra. Watermelon. Going east. Wow. Here's your cantaloupe. Oh yeah, these are cantaloupe. Your traditional cantaloupe too. It's got the, look like fleshy. Like a flesh color skin. And it's rough. You see that? 1, 2, 3. Last year we had them out here and raccoon got them, tore them up. There's 3 down there right now at least. There's probably more, but it's hard to see with these leaves. But you see those 3. Those are cantaloupe. And like I say, honeydews are mixed in here. And then cucumber also. And then there's more honeydew over there. That's where that tomato plant is mixed in with that. Where I got that hornworm yesterday from. So it's hot out here, folks. Okay, that sunflower is a mammoth. I don't know, it's got different heads coming off too. This is about 7 feet tall right now. Up there. So you can see a head. Oh, I can't see this viewfinder. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Head right there. One right there. Right there, see how they're branching off. I always thought the mammoth just was the solo stalk, one head for head on top, but I'm not a horticulturist. I've said that in almost every video I've said, so I plant Titan and, gosh, I can't catch my breath out here. Titan and mammoth, I know, and other things, but see, sunflowers around the edge were dying off because of the shit they, well, the stuff they sprayed out there on that Monsanto food-like product, so... It's hot out here, folks. I'm going in the house. I'm going to leave the eggshells over there. There's a container with some old ones in there. Just mix them all together. It don't matter about them being young and old, I don't think. It'll just help deter the insects. But there's still some big zucchinis in here, so I'm not going to be able to get to it. I just want to show you how high up they are. They're at least 3.5, maybe 4 feet high. That's at least 4 feet high, that one there. But this has got disease. I don't have another spray bottle. I only have one. That's why I have the dishwashing liquid with water for insects. Otherwise, I put some baking soda in there and spray on these in the evening and get rid of this mildewy stuff. And those would bounce back. They've done it every time in the past because they get it, and then I spray it, and they come back, and they look just like these. Fresh green looking. You see, whenever you start getting louder, you get a white powdery look on it. That's like a disease on it. And again, I can't do it because I don't have one bottle, one spray bottle. Buy the cheap crap from Dollar Tree, and then after about four uses, none use. I've bought four at a time, and I've had probably about 12 total. I've got one left. So there's what they say, you get what you pay for. Yeah, I guess when you ain't got money, you gotta buy what you can and make do. Whew. I'll never win the lottery or the Powerball or what do you call it, Mega Millions. I know it sounds stupid to a lot of people, but it's just like, well, I said I'd be happy with just $1 million, just $1 million. But well, dude, I'll have a garden very similar to this, but it'll be a lot more organized, I'll tell you that much. It will have plastic on the bottom, too. I probably bought from the store. This is from a grower who sells the stuff and hauls it to wherever the market was. And I cut it open, my wife and I, and this is hard as hell. This last time, we tilled up everything out here after we took the plastic off, and it was next to killing us. We will not move the plastic again. We will just use the holes that we have. See, constantly trying to pull up the grass and stuff out of here. One of these days I'm going to do this and there'll be a snake down here. I try to shake it, get all the extra soil back on it. So, yeah, we found a rabbit's leg right over here. It was buried. One of my dogs was on it. My wife said, oh, she's eating a leg. And I ran over here. It was a rabbit's leg about 24 inches long. Pretty good size. I'm just filming this. That's it, so... 7 foot. Oh, see, this stuff here grows through here. I just pull it up. I mean, I can't get in there. I'm not going to reach in there really either because, you know, it's on the edge here. That grass gets long and gets in there. Not really going to hurt it, but I don't like seeing it, so I pull it out a lot of times. Yeah, this is all watermelon, and it gets some honeydew and cantaloupe. I can't believe those cantaloupes. I better not get these. I will shoot whatever I see out here from now on. If I see anything out this way, come out here at night with my laser anyway. Come over this way and you'll hear shots in the middle of the night. I hope I don't hit none of these melons. Well, I shouldn't if I'm aiming at something with a laser. But anyway, there you go. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Grow yourself some food. You keep eating the crap that you're buying in the store and you're going to end up sick and dying. Oh wait, that's what they want. So, I'm not sick or dying. Well, I mean, we're all dying, but I'm getting more nutrition out of this stuff than you'll ever get in the crap in the store. I'm serious. I mean, there's no two ways around it. Heirloom Solutions is where I got my seeds from, started back in 2010 or 2011, and getting seeds every year. And like I said, once you get a pack of seeds, 10 seeds even, I got like probably about 40 or 50 packs of seeds at least. You get one pack of everything, and that'll last you for 3 or 4 generations, and then some, you know, just because they're heirloom, they'll grow continuously. It's all the toxic crap around you that's doing any harm to anything, so. All right, folks. Did the best I can. I keep trying to tell you, grow your own food, you'll eat food. Go to the store, and you'll eat whatever it is they give you and tell you it's food.